period between the implementation of the Cole Protocol and the end of the war is often referred to as the Siege of the Inner Colonies. For humanity, this was a time of silent dread, frequently punctuated by the Covenant's ruthless eradication of a colony. Although human worlds were not being destroyed at a pace that they had been earlier in the war, there was still little to stop the Covenant's steady advance through human territory. Everyone, welcome back to Installation 00 and this episode 11 of the Mythos, where I narrate each entry in the Mythos book into their own dedicated videos. Today we continue with the Siege of the Inner Colonies. Although there were a handful of victories for humanity during the Siege of the Inner Colonies, these were only minor setbacks in the Covenant's campaign. Propaganda and willful ignorance kept the innermost colonies, and in particular the Sol system, detached from the actual horrors taking place. But for those who grasped the scale of the threat, the extinction of mankind seemed to be guaranteed. On July 17th, 2552, Covenant scouting vessels struck the lush jungle colony of Sigma Octanus IV. Only a single human ship, the UNSC Iroquois, survived the initial attack. It was here that Commander Jacob Keyes displayed his naval skills by conducting one of the most impressive tactical maneuvers in UNSC history. The ploy that came to be known as the Keyes Loop. The epitome of loyalty and bravery, Jacob Keyes had a diverse and unorthodox history of service within the UNSC Navy. Though eventually returning to combat, Keyes spent a number of years serving as an instructor at the Luna OCS, Officer Candidate School, due to injuries sustained on the Meriwether Lewis. Before this, he even served as military escort for Catherine Halsey in a heavily classified scouting operation for Spartan II candidates. Keyes was no stranger to naval combat and already had decades of experience. His narrow but brilliant victory in this skirmish would finally gain him fame and the rank of captain. Only hours later, however, the enemy returned, this time bringing immense invasion-scale numbers in the form of the Covenant's second fleet of Solemn Accord. The Battle of Sigma Octanus IV had begun. Marines and Spartans struck the heart of the Covenant's planet-side invasion, while the UNSC Navy fought in orbit. The Covenant's specific goals for this colony were revealed when Spartans located a concentration of enemy forces at a museum in the city of Côte d'Azur. The aliens were transmitting data from a fossilized stone recovered by human colonists long ago. Far above the city, a Covenant vessel attempted to capture this data, but was waylaid by Keyes' Iroquois before it was acquired. The data was instead collected by the Iroquois' crew and, amazingly, what was left of the second fleet of Solemn Accord fled from the remaining UNSC forces. The unexpected victory at Sigma Octanus IV came at a critical time in the war, but it would be weeks before the true implications were revealed. Hidden within the data the aliens had so desperately sought were the coordinates for an ancient weapon far beyond the power of anything the humans or the Covenant possessed, as well as a secret that would forever change the course of the war. With only a few dozen colonies remaining, Oni believed it was a matter of months, if not weeks, before the Covenant arrived at Reach, and then Earth would be next on the list. To prevent this, Oni planned for Spartans to strike at the heart of the Covenant, abduct one of their prophets, and hold them hostage, hoping to force the enemy into a truce. This plan was called Operation Red Flag. Over the course of the war, the Spartans had become legendary. From their actions were spun tales of valor and glory. They were icons of hope, constantly defying reason and logic, and gaining victory over innumerable threats. Among the Spartans, one had stood above the rest in renown and accomplishment. Master Chief Petty Officer John 117. He would become the central figure in the design of Red Flag, carrying its critical mission asset deep into enemy territory. Born on the rebellion-embroiled colony of Aridnus II in 2511, John was integrated into the Spartan II program at the age of 6. While his training and augmentation were not unique among his peers, he gained a reputation among them as a born leader, spearheading a number of operations at an impressively young age. Shortly after the war began, he rose to the rank of Master Chief Petty Officer, a title which would become synonymous with him. Prior to Red Flag, John had fought in over 200 individual military engagements, both on the ground and in space. He had been awarded every single major medal in combat except for prisoner of war. Even among the legendary Spartans, he was without equal. For this reason, he was selected to be a vital component in the Red Flag operation. The chief would be given Cortana, an incredibly advanced AI construct capable of subverting and infiltrating Covenant systems. The information she possessed was crucial for humanity's victory, and the chief would be her protector. The fate of the war would rest on their shoulders. Thanks for watching. Stick your comments down below, and I look forward to what you have to say. And quick shout outs and thank yous to my patrons, Spartan10148, my devastatingly effective Metarch class Ancilla, Silver Spartan, Leon, Ram, Prophet Bear, and Irrefutable Justice, my ever-vigilant monitors, the careful tending of Alvin, Andrew, Brian, Cameron, Darien, Devon, Phantom, Flaming Halo, Cabal, Legions Lost, Michael, Spartan0137, the Cave Potato, and Wolf Eclipse, my sub-monitors, my growing fleet of Strato Sentinels, and my most loyal of enforcers, and all my awesome Sentinels, Sentries, and Constructors who have jumped aboard on Patreon to help support the channel. you have my debt of gratitude. And, as ever, Todd Morrison, my Tier 0 Transcendent YouTube member. Thanks for keeping my installation running on that glorious vacuum energy. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, as it all helps the channel grow and helps me to continue to deliver this kind of content for you guys. And if you're ready for your next steps in evolution, head over to Patreon and become a patron there, or become a YouTube member to attain a higher state of being. Much love to all of you, take it easy everyone, and find peace in the domain.